So now we go to stage one, which is the, sorry, stage three, which is the last stage, because we have done stage one where we allocate to store three alone. We've done stage two, which is dealing with allocating for stage two and what? Store two and what? Store three. Then we are going to go to stage three where we want to allocate forward, store three, two, and what? One, because it's backward computation. We are allocating cumulatively. Don't forget the rule. So based on that now, we are at stage three where we are allocating four, store three, store two, and what? Store one in that backward computation manner. So don't forget, in at stage three, we are dealing with what we are looking to store three, two, and one, and specifically we are interested in what happens to store one. So what happens is, don't forget, the allocation starts with store one, and you are beginning with what, 6 gallons of milk. So if you have 6 gallons of milk, so you don't really need to experiment to say you need to look at 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, because when you have the 6 gallons of milk, you start thinking to say, when I go to store one, because I move from store one to store two, store three, when I start with store one, I have 6 gallons available, what should I allocate, take into consideration the possible demand? Should I allocate 0, 1, 2, or what, 3? So that's the reason why when I do this last stage computation, which is stage three, I just go straight to 6 as my state, because I'm starting with 6 gallons of milk, and I want to see, should I allocate 0, 1, or 2 to what? Stage two, to what? 0, 1, 2, or 3 to what? Store one. Even though we know that stage three cumulatively we are dealing with what? Store three, two, and one in that recursive computation. So please take note of that. So that means, because we are allocating to store one, we are starting with 6 gallons, just go straight to 6 gallons in stage three, which is the last stage. So based on this now, you just write your 6, and the possible allocations can either be 0, 1, 2, or what? 3. So that means 6 can be, when 6 is available, when 6 is available, should we allocate 0, 1, 2, or 3? That's what we want to, investigate. At this stage, we like to allocate 0, 1, 2, or 3 towards store 1. That is what we want to investigate at this stage. So let's see how it works. So if I allocate 0 to store 1, so that means R1 of 0, you remember we got it as what? We got it as 0. R1 of 0 was 0. As you can see on the board, R1 of 0 was 0. Then our R2 of S1 minus G1, don't forget, is a cumulative, because we are cumulating backward. So don't forget, at stage 3, we need the result of our stage 2. So that's why we're going back to R2. Don't forget, to 2, we need to recall the result of what? We need to recall the result of stage 1, which is R3, in terms of what you have allocated to store 3. So don't forget, those cumulative recursive computations need to come in, like I usually tell you in that class. So that's why we have R2 of S1 minus what? G1. Please, I think you're supposed to get that. So R2 of S1 minus G1 means R2. Because we need to recall at stage 3, we need to recall our result at stage 2, which is 6 minus 0. So that will give you R2 of 6 minus 0, which is R2 of what? 6. And remember, our R2 of 6, we got it to be equal to, we got our result for our R2 of 6, we got it to be equal to 8.7. And check your stage 2 result. R2 of 6 was 8.7. So when you add this together, 0 plus 8.7, it will give you what? 8.7. You cannot write this result until you analyze all the possible options, because this is investigating the best or the maximum expected remaining. So let's go ahead and check. If 6 was available, we allocate 1 to store 1. What is our revenue? That is R1 of what? 2. Sorry, R1 of 1. We have R1 of 1. If 1 gallon of milk was 6 gallon of milk was available, and we allocate 1, so to store 1, it means that we're looking for R1 of 1, and R1 of 1, as you can see here, is what, 2, so which is 2. And from there, you need to go and investigate your R2 of S1 minus G1 at this current state, which is R2 of 6 minus 1, which is R2 of what? 5. So our R2 of 5, if you check your previous, your stage 2 computation, your R2 of 5 gave you your R2 of 5 please give you, please note that this result is the best result in terms of the best. This R2 that we're talking about, R2 of S1 minus G1, is referring to your best revenue in stage two. Please let me know that. That your R2 of S1 minus G1 is referring to as your best revenue in stage two at that particular state that you're investigating. That's why for the first one, you know, it was R2 of 6, and our best revenue value was what, 8.7. That's why we got 8.7. So don't forget, that was the maximum revenue, which is 8.7. So we got it there as our R2 of S1 minus G1, which is the best, which is the maximum revenue. At R2 of what? R2 of 5. That's what we got, 8.7. So the same thing, we need to apply the same principle here. R2 of 6 minus 1, that is R2 of 5. What is our maximum revenue at R2 of 5? Our maximum revenue at R2 of 5. Our maximum revenue at R2 of 5 was 7.75. So that means you need to write 7.75 here. So then we add these together, that gives us 9.75. And now let's go to this particular, to the next possible allocation. If I allocated 2, I have 6 gallons available. If I allocated 2 to store 1, that is R1 of what? 2, which I got as what? 3.10. So that means this will give me 3.10. And that means my R2 of S1 minus G1, which is the best revenue in stage 2 for this particular state, which is 6 minus 2, R2 of 6 minus 2, which is R2 of 4. So my best revenue there, which is R2 of 4. My best revenue at R2 of 4, I got it as what? 6.65. So this gives me 6.65. Check your stage 2. At your R2 of 4, your best revenue was 6.65. Just try to check it. At your R2 of 4, your best revenue was 6.65. Then when you add these together, that will give you also 9.75. So for the last option, let's compute, we're almost there. For the last option, we have 6 gallons available. We allocate 3. If we had allocated 3 to store 1, that is what will be our revenue for doing that. So allocating 3 to store 1, that is R1 of 3. We've calculated it as what? 4.20. So that is what you are seeing here, which is 4.20. So you write it here. So your best revenue for doing that in stage 2, let's check it. That is 6 minus R2 of 6 minus 3, which is R2 of what? 3. So what was my best revenue for R2 of 3 in stage 2, my best revenue was what? 5.4. So that is 5.4. You need to check that best revenue solution in stage 2, because you are calling your solution in stage 2 and putting it in stage 1. So if you add this together, this will give you what? 9.6. So now you need to check. Now you can now write what is your best. You can write what is your best revenue, or the maximum revenue, because you have analyzed all the possible options. Which of these revenue gives the highest value? It's 9.75. We have it twice. So we have 9.75 as the best revenue. And the possible allocations that gave us that was what? It's either we allocate, because 9.75 we got it when we allocate 1 or 1 gallon to store 1, or allocate 2 gallons to what? Store. When we allocate 1 gallon to store 1, or when we allocate 2 gallons to store 1. So that means my G2 can be equal to, sorry, my G, I'm dealing with my G1 star, not G2, because we had store 1. So my G1 can be equal to, the best allocation can be equal to what? 1, or G1 should be equal to what? 2. So that is the best allocation. So if you want to now see, at this stage, we have already did all the computation, analyze all the possible allocations and possible revenue we can get. So based on this computation, because that this is the last stage, how do we get the best allocation that we need to now put that we need to allocate to each stop based on these are results of our stage coach competition for stage one, stage two, stage three. So the way we know it is you can see we start with stage three, which is the last stage. That's how we read the result. You'll be able to see what is your best allocation to stop one. Just start from here. The best allocation can be either what G1 equal to 1 or G1 equal to 2. So it can either be this or this for your stop one. You can either allocate 1 gallon to stop one or 1 or 2 gallon to stop one. So let me start with the first option. You have decided to allocate 1 gallon to store one. So solution one could be G1 equal to what? 1. So then what would be my G2 in terms of the allocation to store 2? How do I read it? I need to read it by tracing. Remember, G1 equal to 1 is the one I'm looking at now. So, and it means that for me to trace my result of what I must allocate in to store 2, I need to see the result in what stage 2, because I'm at stage 3. So I only see the result of allocation of store 1 in stage 3. So to see the result of allocation of store 2, I need to see it in what stage 2. So how do I trace this result back to stage 2? I need to go and check, normally I'm saying G1 equal to 1. So I need to go and check what is the corresponding R2 that I need to check. So for me to know that, remember I'm saying G1 equal to 1, which is this one, and the S1 there is what, 6. So that means if I want to know what I must trace, it must be 6 minus 1. So that means I must go and trace what is my R2 of 6 minus 1. And that means I need to go and trace what is the best allocation for R2 of 6 minus 1, which is R2 of what, 5. So you go to stage 2, you can check in stage 2. When we get to R2 of 5, you will see that the best allocation was what? The maximum allocation in that stage 2 was 7.75. And the R2 that gave us that value was what? It was 3. The allocation the allocation that gave us that 7.75 was 3. So that means your G2 must be equal to what? 3. Just try to check it in your previous combination. So that's how we trace the result. So then if you want to trace what your result will look like in, what your allocation will be for stage, what your allocation will be for store 3, you need to also trace it from that R2 of 5 by trying to get, okay, what was available at that R2 of 5 and what was allocated. So what was available at that R2 of 5, you remember, it was 5. It was 5, because to trace it, you trace it by looking at what was available at that R2 of 5, which was 5 was available at the state, and what was allocated was what? 3. Because we saw that the best allocation was 3 to store 2. So to be able to trace the result in store 3, you check what was available at that particular R2 of 5, which is 5. And what is allocated, which is 3, and to help you to trace it back to the R of 3. To help you to stay trace it back to the R of 3, to what you need to check for in stage one. So which is R3 of 5 minus 3. So that means you need to go and check what was your best allocation in R3 of what? 2. So if you go and check what is your best allocation in R3 of 2, so then don't forget your best allocation is 2. Also what allocate what? 2 gallons. You check it in stage 1. So that means you need to allocate 2 gallons. So try to check it and to trace it backward from your stage 3 to stage 2 and stage 1. So this is one solution. Another solution following this approach, if I had, the reason why I have 2 solutions is because in my stage 3, my G1 can either be 1 or what? 2. So I've experimented the solution when my G1 equal to 1. So I didn't know my G1 was equal to 2. How would my other allocation look like? My allocation for store 1, if it can be equal to 2, then it would have implied that for me to be able to trace my allocation of stage 2, for me to be able to trace how many gallons of milk I need to put in stage 2, I need to check what is available with respect to what I allocated here, which is G1 equal to 2. You can see, terms of what was allocated in terms of gym and quantity, you see at 2. Then what was available is what? 6. I need to go and check R12, 6 minus 2. So that means I need to go and check R12, what? 4. So if I check R12, 4, I need to check what is the best allocation there. And that will tell me the best allocation to store 2. So for R204, I'm going to need to check it, and I will be able to see that my best allocation there was to allocate also 2 gallons. So I need to allocate 2 gallons. So if I do that, I also need to now use that to trace it back to get what must be my G3 from stage 2 to see what was my allocation at that R204, what was my allocation, what was available, to be able to trace it back to the first stage. So you see that in this case, I have in that R204, what was available was what? What was available was 4. Then what was allocated was what? What was allocated was 2. Because what was allocated at that R204 was 2, because that is I got this. It means that I must allocate, that means I must go and check what is my best allocation at R3 of what? 2. So my best allocation at R3 of 2, you can check it, is still to allocate what? 2 gallons to what? Store 3. So that means from in the stage 1. Because you check what is my best allocation for R3 of 2 in stage 1 for the store 3 allocation, you see that we got in that stage 1 that G3 must be worth what? 2. So that's how we get the solution. And that is the 2 possible solution for this particular problem. Possible allocation solution of the milk to each of the stores. So what this solution is saying is, for solution 1, allocate 1 gallon of milk to store 1, 3 gallon of milk to store 2, and 2 gallon of milk to what? Store 3, and make a maximum revenue of what? $9.75. So that is what the solution is saying. Or another allocation could have been, allocate 2 gallon of milk to store 1, 2 gallon of milk to store 2, or 2 gallon of milk to store 3, and make a maximum revenue of what? $9.75. So that is the solution to this problem. So I would implore you to try all the tutorial questions that I've sent to you, and make sure you practice all these questions so you're able to understand this concept well. So we're going to look at some other examples in another session that I'm going to have with you soon. Thank you very much.